Hello guys, welcome to your class. This is Sunita and today we are going to read chapter The Birth from Snapshot written by A.J. Cronin. Let us see the summary. This chapter is an extract from A.J. Cronin's novel The Citadel. Okay, this the chapter which we are going to read, this is an extract of A.J. Cronin's novel. The name of the novel is The Citadel. This extract describes how a young doctor revives a child that is born lifeless. Revives means usko kaise dobara zindagi deta hai. So Joe Morgan and his wife were a middle-aged couple. Couple means middle-aged, you can say, like around 40s. This is middle age. They have been married for 20 years but have not got any child so far. Now Mrs. Morgan is expecting her first child. So after 20 years of their married life, they were going to get a baby. They were expecting a baby and this was their first baby. So both her husband and her mother are feeling very nervous. Means whose husband? Mrs. Morgan's husband and Mrs. Morgan's mother. They were feeling very nervous. Why they were nervous? Because the delivery of the child is going to be before time. This was a premature delivery. That's why they all were nervous. A young doctor named Andrew is called in. And the doctor was called and the name of the doctor is Andrew. The doctor has to put in hard labor in the delivery of the child. When the child is born, it seems to be stillborn. Stillborn means the lifeless baby. Okay, means unko aisa lag raha tha that the baby was dead, that it had no life. This shock could be too much for the Morgans to bear. And according to doctor, in fact, for anyone, after 20 years, they were getting a baby. And if the baby was lifeless, then the situation can be imagined by anyone. So now here are the main characters which we are going to discuss about. Dr. Andrew Manson. This is the doctor and first character and very important character. Okay, and these are the imaginary pictures. These are not real pictures. Okay, so these pictures are only to make you people understand better. So this is newly qualified doctor, takes a job as assistant to Dr. Page in a small mining town. Okay, so mining town means where the most people of the town work in coal mines. That such kind of cities or towns are called mining town. So takes a job as an assistant to Dr. Page. Page is partly paralyzed and will never work again. And now Dr. Page, he is partly paralyzed and he will not be able to work again. So Dr. Andrew Manson will have to do most of the clinic's work in this mining town at a meager pay. Okay, major pay means that very low cost पे बहुत कम पैसे लेके और इसको सारे के सारे काम अब डॉक्टर एंड्रयू मैनसन को ही करने पड़ेंगे इस माइनिंग टाउन में. पे कम क्यों लेनी है? बिकॉज द पीपल आर नॉट सो रिच, दे आर पुअर, दे आर लेबर्स एंड दे आर वर्किंग इन कोल माइन. सो यू कैन जस्ट इमेजिन दे आर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज मिडवाइफ. मिडवाइफ बोले तो दाई. हाँ, अगर आपको हिंदी में अगर पता हो तो मिडवाइफ क्या बोलते हैं? दाई बोलते हैं. लाइक नर्स, यू नो व्हाट इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मिडवाइफ एंड अ नर्स? नर्स इज़ अ प्रोफेशनल बट द मिडवाइफ इज़ नॉट अ प्रोफेशनल. ओके, द मिडवाइफ डजंट गेट एनी प्रोफेशनल ट्रेनिंग फॉर सच वर्क, बट अ नर्स गेट्स अ प्रोफेशनल दैट ट्रेनिंग. So midwife, an experienced nurse. She has experience but she has not got any professional training. So the midwife and Andrew are contrasting personalities. These two personalities, Andrew and the midwife, They are opposite personalities. Let us see first about midwife. She feels hopeless. She has no hope, okay, about the child. When she saw the child lifeless, she lost her all the hope, okay. Resigned, she doesn't have any professional training, although she has experience, okay, and she feels helpless, fearful and untrained. She has not got any professional training. So resign means peaceful. Her nature is peaceful. She is hopeless, मतलब एक optimist होता है बंदा, और एक hopeless मतलब जो एक pessimist type की personality है ये. So Andrew proves to be more optimistic. Andrew कहता है he is more optimistic, he is आशावादी type का बंदा है ये. Diligent, hard working है, efficient इसके अंदर qualities हैं, and self sufficient, and he feels that he was only he means he could do his work himself only. Spontaneous means he can just act on the spot, मतलब on the spot उसको decision जो लेना होता है, जो उसके मन में आता है वो कर देता है, and well trained person. Next is Joe Morgan. Joe Morgan is a well-built person in 14. Well-built person means हटा कटा आदमी है, and in 40s he is in 40s. So he is in 40s, lives in a small Welsh town of Blanley. He lives in a town of Blanley, works as a driller at the mine, because I told you most of the people of this town, they work in coal mines. He has been married for 20 years, have not got any child so far. Next character is Mrs. Morgan, wife of Joe Morgan, expecting her first child. Okay, both her husband and her mother are feeling very nervous, because first of all, that after 20 years they were expecting a baby, and the second one, that the delivery was a premature delivery. So delivery of the child is going to be before time. Next is Christine. Christine is the girlfriend of Dr. Andrew Malson. Okay, she is a school teacher. Andrew falls in love with her. Next is Morgan's mother. Okay, so she is a tall lady, gray-haired. Okay, gray-haired means white hair. Okay, safed baal hai unke, and nearly 70s. You know, Joe Morgan's, they are in 40s, and the mother of Morgan's, she is in her 70s. So now let us see a quick summary of this chapter. After that, we are going to just read the chapter line by line. But this is a kind of summary, just a summary. Andrew Malson was a young doctor. He had newly passed out of a medical school and joined as an assistant to Dr. Edward Page. I told you that he has just newly passed out his medicines, and now he has started to work as an assistant to Dr. Edward Page. Their clinic was in a small Welsh town of Blanley. It was a mining town. Joe Morgan was a resident of this town. He was a well-built person and worked as a driller at the mines. He lived with his wife. Then they had married for about 20 years, but so far they didn't have any child. Now Mrs. Morgan was expecting her first child. So I think the language is very easy, and you can simply understand what is going on here in the summary. Joe Morgan and Mr. and Mrs. Joe Morgan, after 20 years they were going to have a child, and Dr. Andrew Malson, he was a newly passed doctor, and he works as an assistant with the Dr. Edward Page. Now, after spending a disappointing evening with his lady love, who is just spending a disappointing evening, Dr. Andrew Malson, okay, with his love lady, okay, means Kristen. Disappointing meeting means maybe that they had a dispute or something, some quarrels or all something like that, और समथिंग लाइक उनके बीच में कोई झगड़ा वगैरह हो गया होगा. सो दैट इवनिंग वॉज अ डिसअपॉइंटिंग इवनिंग. क्रिस्टीन एंड्रयू केम बैक, क्रिस्टीन विद हिज लव लेडी क्रिस्टीन. सो एंड्रयू केम बैक होम, ही फाउंड मोगन वेटिंग फॉर हिम रेस्टलेसली. रेस्टलेसली मीन्स बहुत ही एक नर्वसनेस के साथ और बहुत ज़्यादा वरिड था, वरिड थे मिस्टर मॉर्गन. सो ही वॉज वेटिंग फॉर हिम. वो बैठ के वेट नहीं कर रहे थे, वो बिल्कुल इधर उधर चहलकदमी करके और अप एंड डाउन जा रहे थे स्ट्रीट में, कभी क्लिनिक पे, कभी घर पे. तो ही वॉज वेटिंग फॉर हिम. ही टोल्ड द डॉक्टर दैट ही हैड बीन वेटिंग फॉर हिम फॉर एन आवर. He said that his wife needed his presence because the child was expected to be born before time. Together they set out for Morgan's house. Okay, Andrew was feeling very dull and tired. Why Andrew was feeling very dull and tired? Because his evening was very disappointing. First of all, he worked the whole day. Okay, and it was a night time. And after the work, he went to his love lady, and that was also a very disappointing. So there was nothing good in the day. That's why he was feeling very dull and tired. When they reached the door of the of number 12, Morgan stopped outside the door. He said that he won't go inside. A narrow stair up to a small bedroom. It was clean but poorly furnished. It was lit only by an oil lamp. Mrs. Morgan's mother was sitting beside the patient. She was a tall, grey-haired woman of nearly 70s. An elderly midwife was also there. Both of them watched Andrew's expression as he moved about the room. Now, Andrew and Mr. Morgan, they went to the house of Mr. Morgan, and there, what did he saw that the patient was there, and one midwife and the mother of Morgan's, she was also there. So both the midwife and the mother of the Morgan's, you know, everybody was just nervous because the after a long time, it was a they were expecting a baby, and it was a premature delivery. So somewhere everybody had a fear that what will happen means everybody was afraid of the situation. That's why they were just noticing the expression of the doctor. Now, since there was a period of waiting, Andrew went them, and soon he was lost in the thoughts about Christine. An hour later, he went upstairs again. He noted the progress made by the maid and came down once more. He sat down by the kitchen fire. Okay, now the doctor is keeping an eye on the patient, that what was going on there, and he was just noting down the progress of the patient, and again he just went to the again he went to the kitchen fire. Now at last the nurse voice was heard calling from the top landing. Andrew looked at the clock. It was now short 3:30, and he rose and went up to the bedroom. He saw that he could now begin his work. An hour passed. It was a long, hard struggle. Then at the first rays of the dawn appeared. The child was born. Lifeless. Dawn is the time of the day when means before the sunrise of the before the sunrise and after a bright day. As Andrew looked at the lifeless from a shiver, now he could decide whether to resuscitate the child first or to attend the mother, who herself was in a serious state. Okay, instinctively he gave the child to the nurse and turned his attention to Susan Morgan, means Mrs. Morgan, who now lay collapsed, almost almost pulseless, he gave her an injection, and after a few minutes of feverish effort means that the nervous effort means he was nervous, he was not understanding, he was not able to understand what was right and what was not, but he was just giving his effort nervously. So Sam's heart gained strength and now he could safely leave her. So after the condition, when he just saw Mrs. Morgan was also in a very serious situation and the child was also. So first of all, he just decided to pay attention towards the mother. And when he saw that the mother was in a favorable condition, then he just left her. And now swinging round to the nurse, asked where's the child. When Andrew looked at the child, he at once knew that it was in case of asphyxia. Okay, instantly he was on his feet. अब जैसे उसने बच्चे को अपने हाथ में लिया, he got to know that he was suffering from a disease and the name of the disease is asphyxia. Get me hot water and cold water, he said to the nurse. And basins too, quick, he took a blanket and laid the child upon it. Then he began the special method to respiration. The basins arrived. Andrew put cold water into the other. He mixed water as hot as his hand could bear. Then, like a crazy juggler, he hurried the child between the two basins. Now he plunged it into the icy water. Now it into the hot one. 15 minutes passed. Sweat was now running into Andrew's eyes. His breath was coming pantingly, but no breath came from the body of the child. Now, as he just got to know, asphyxia is a disease when a person or a child just feels a trouble to breathe. Okay, so breathing problem hai, respiration problem ki wajah se ye bimari hai, iski saans nahi aata hai, and that's why the baby was lifeless. And then he just thought, you know, once he saw this process somewhere, so he just thought that he was going to just try that. It was something like that, if it worked, then it would be a great chance for Mr. and Mrs. Morgan. Otherwise, nothing could be done before the wish of God. So he just took some hot water and cold water, and then उसने क्या किया कि एक बार उस बच्चे को हॉट वाटर में डुबाया, एक बार हॉट वाटर में डुबाया, एक बार कोल्ड वाटर में, एक बार हॉट में, एक बार कोल्ड में, हॉट में, कोल्ड में, हॉट में, कोल्ड में, इस तरीके से बच्चे को, इस तरीके से उसके अंदर जो है ना बच्चे को डुबोता चला गया. और 15 मिनट्स के बाद, यू नो, ही वॉज जस्ट द स्वेट वॉज रनिंग ओवर हिज आइज, सो पसीने में लथपथ हो गया था वो. एंड स्टिल देर वॉज नो ब्रेथ इन द चाइल्ड. A terrible sense of defeat came on him, having labored in vain for half an hour. He still made one last effort. He rubbed the child with a rough towel. He pressed and released the little chest with both of his hands. Thus, he tried to get breath into that limp body. Limp body means lifeless body. Now, what did he do? अब उसने क्या किया? Baby को एक rough towel से पोंछ दिया, and then he pressed the back of the child in this way, as the video, as the picture has been shown. And then so he was hoping that maybe that there may be a breath in this limp body. Then a miracle happened. The little chest gave a short heave, matlab ek saans aaya usko. Andrew continued with his effort feverishly. The child had started gasping deeper and deeper. A bubble of mucus means hamare nose se jo dust nikalta hai to mucus bahar aata hai. Okay, come from one tiny nostril. The limbs were no longer boneless. और जो उसकी हाथ पैर थे वो अब पहले boneless दिखाई दे रहे थे, क्योंकि उनमें life ही नहीं थी. बट अब वो इतने बोनलेस दिखाई नहीं देते. द हेड नो लॉन्गर ले बैक स्पाइनलेस. पहले उसकी जो गर्दन थी वो भी नीचे झुक रही थी क्योंकि इसके अंदर लाइफ ही नहीं थी. बट नाउ इट वॉज बेटर एंड द स्किन वॉज स्लोली टर्निंग पिंक. और जो स्किन है वो स्लोली स्लोली पिंक में टर्न हो रही थी. Exquisitely came the child's cry. Andrew handed the child to the nurse. He went downstairs and took a long drink of water. And then he just handed over the child to the nurse, meet the midwife. And then he took a long drink of water. Means काफ़ी सारा उसने पानी पिया. He took his hat and coat and left the house outside. He found Joe Morgan standing on the pavement with a tense, expectant face. All right, Joe. Who said this? Doctor Joe. Andrew Melson said this. That Joe, everything is all right. Said Andrew. Both all right.